everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel, mgrahamsews. This video tutorial is for this really cute and speedy sew called the Speedy Wristlet. This wristlet can be made in many different ways. So there is options for adding a crossbody strap. There's different sizes. So this is the large, but there's a medium, a small, a coin purse size. You can add one wristlet. You can add two D-rings here to make a crossbody. You can make it into a little hip bag. So there's lots of options with this. And even though there's all these options, it really truly is a fast sew. And I know the tutorial does take a little bit of time, but that's because I'm really going into detail to show you things, but you'll be able to speed through this, especially after you make it once, and you'll be whipping up a whole bunch of these in no time. So let's discuss some of the features. Now, as I was mentioning, there are different options for the straps. So I made the wristlet for this one, which is really nice. And if I make any more with these materials, I can just use the same wristlet and attach and take it off if I want, or slip the smaller sizes into here. So on the front, we have this little zipper pocket and it is finished. I do have a material in the lining, but you can leave that so that there is no lining material. Flip it to the other side, and this helps you see inside the little wristlet. And there are card slots here, and I did the triple card slot on that side, so there's three card slots, and then a slip pocket on the other side right here. I'm trying to show you so you can see the slip pocket right there. And you can add more card slots on this side if you want. You can just do two slip pockets, card slots. You can even add a card slot in here, one of the card slots here, a single card slot. The choice is really yours. There's lots of options. This can fit my phone comfortably in the large. So there you go. The large fits my phone comfortably. No problem. I don't know if it fits in the front pocket. Let's find out. So if it fits in the front pocket, and it does. And my phone is a bigger phone with the case on it, and it fits in there. So that's awesome that it fits. And again, this is the large size. Lots of different sizes to make. You can make these really fun and cute like I did here, or you can make it for, say you have an event to go to and you need something dressy, but you don't want to carry around a big bag. This would be really perfect. You can even add the little crossbody strap. You can just put the extra D-ring on this side, and then you have the option to wear a crossbody or have the wristlet if you want. Lots of options. You'll definitely want to read through the pattern first before you get started, because as I said, with all the options, there's so many to choose from, you're probably going to have a hard time choosing which one to make. So I'm going to walk you through everything. And as I'm walking you through, as I mentioned, I do show you everything. Nothing is sped up. This is filmed just like a sew along. So there's no parts where I speed it up. I just keep going. So if there's at any point you're finding that it's taking really long, for example, when I'm pulling threads through and tying them off, you can speed up the video. You can zoom in. You can mute the volume. Do whatever you want. This is just really here, this video, to help and guide you through making the pattern. So any parts, say if you get stuck somewhere and you're not really sure, the video is there to help guide you through if you get stuck or if you just need that extra bit of help. So let's get started making our Speedy Wristlets by DEJA Designs. So the very first thing you'll want to do is read through the entire pattern. This is very important because designers give different information regarding interfacings to use. Maybe the materials you're using won't require interfacing. Sometimes pattern pieces are cut a little bit differently depending on materials you are using. So you'll want to read through to familiarize yourself with the pattern and also make note of any changes that are made due to materials you're making. This pattern does have a lot of information, so you definitely want to read it. And there's a lot of information because there's multiple sizes and different designs in terms of how you can cut these pieces. So there's rounded corners or straight edge corners like I've cut here. So you'll want to make note of that as well when you're cutting. There's also different pattern pieces for card slots. So you'll also want to choose which one you want to make before you get cutting your fabrics, as well as choosing how you want to do a wrist strap, whether you want to add it or you don't. I'm going to walk you through all the steps of making these, and I'm choosing to do the triple card slot. So this is the same as doing the double and the single. You'll just sew it a little bit differently, but I wanted to do this because this one does require a bit more sewing and maybe a bit more information, and it may be a little bit confusing. So I've decided to go with that. I'm also doing a wrist strap with the connector here, but there is an option to do the wrist strap without a connector. So I'll show you how to do that, and I'll walk you through how to add a wrist strap without a connector. Like I said, there's lots of options in this pattern. There's options to add a waist belt. I'm not going to show you how to do it, but sewing it in is the exact same way as sewing in a wrist strap. So you'll just follow the same method that we use here in this tutorial. As I mentioned, I did cut my pieces on the corners. I'm using the straight edge angled corner here, not the rounded, so I'm using this one. And the reason why I've went ahead and made all those cuts, including the cuts for where my zipper pocket goes, I've made marks for measurements for where placements are for different pattern pieces. And the reason why I did that is because I don't show any pattern pieces on camera. I don't give any measurements. I don't show rulers. I don't show anything like that that will give away the pattern information. And this is for the protection of the designer, but also because I film tutorials often during testing, and sometimes things can change, such as a measurement. So I don't want to tell you a measurement in the tutorial and then it's incorrect come time when the pattern is actually released and it's different. That can get very confusing and frustrating for you if you're following along with me and realize that it was sewn wrong. So there's no measurements given. You will need to have your pattern either open beside you printed or on a different device or even on the same device and just minimize the video screen so that you can follow along. So once you have read through the entire pattern, you can cut all your pattern pieces like I've done here, which, as I mentioned, I've cut everything including any of the little zipper pocket openings. I've also prepared my zippers, and I've gathered up my hardware, and there is some hardware that I'm using. As I mentioned, I'm attaching a wrist strap with the connector here, so I need my D-ring and my swivel hook. So depending on which one you're making, you may only need zippers or you may need some hardware. Again, lots of options with this pattern. It's wonderful. And the size I'm making for this tutorial is the large. That's just because it's a lot bigger and I feel that you'll be able to see what I'm doing better on the large, and I just thought it would be really super fun to make. So I'm using vinyl for my exterior and a vinyl for my lining. You'll want to use whatever materials, threads, needles, and presser foot that will work best for your machine, but also for the materials you're using. I'm using a Teflon foot because I am sewing with vinyls and I need a Teflon foot, so I am using a Teflon foot. So again, use materials, needles, etc. that you know are best for your machine, but also you know that are best for the materials you have chosen. So let's get started making our Speedy Wristlet. So as I mentioned, you do need to cut your pattern pieces out and attach all your stabilizers, which I have already done. I'm using Decaville Light for my exterior piece here, and I've cut my angles on my corners. So you'll want to go ahead and use your pattern pieces to do that. Now, Andrea does make a note in the pattern for making marks and not going down to the edge, so you don't see this in the finished product, because this is a raw edge pattern or finished bag, so you don't want to see any marks in the raw edges. So Andrea did make a note to not draw your lines going all the way to the bottom. Mine is a heat sensitive one, so I'm going to be able to just kind of sneak my iron in there and I'll be able to get that off when it is done. So there is that. So once I have that and you have that all cut out and you've attached all your stabilizers, I'm just going to move this out of the way. We're ready to get started on making our wrist strap. Now, the wrist strap has a few different options, and the option I'm going to go with is option one. So that's the option I'm going with, and this is what my piece looks like right now. And this is best for thick fabric, she's saying. So if you're using some really thick fabrics, this is a really good option for thick fabrics, and that's the one I'm going to do. But before I start showing you how to do the one I'm going to do, I want to walk you through how to do option two. So if you're using thicker fabrics, but not too thick, this is a great option for those kind of fabrics. And what you'll do is there is a line that you need to draw from one end to the other end, and then you'll place some double-sided tape below that line. Once you have that line drawn, you will fold your fabric up to meet that line, just like that. And I know I don't have the line here, but I'm just showing you, so we'll pretend that the line is there. So you'll fold that up to meet the line. Once you have it folded up to meet that line, you'll then take the other side of your strap and you'll fold it so it wraps over the side you just folded like that. So see how I folded this up, say the line was here? I'm now folding this over and covering that up. So what ends up happening is I only have one raw edge here and then I have no raw edge here. And you'll top stitch along the whole length down both sides of the strap and it'll look like that. So you'll have it folded over like that. Pretty easy, really good for really thick fabric, for those thicker fabrics. So even like the fabric I'm using here, this would be really good for this. Now, if you have thin fabric, so say you're using waterproof canvas for this, this is a great method for you to use here. And this is your regular method that we see for most handles, crossbody straps, and wristlets. And what you do is you mark a line down the center. You then take your fabrics and press both long edges in to meet that center mark you made. So they'll look like that. It's folded in to meet the center here. Just like that. Once you have them folded in the center, you'll then fold this in half again, and you'll have a piece that'll look like that. So where the folds are, and then you'll have one folded edge here. And that encloses all your raw edges. And what you'll do there is you'll stitch down the entire length of the strap on both sides. And that'll give you a strap or wristlet that'll look like this with no raw edges because they're all concealed inside the middle there. Now, a little tip, when you're folding into the center here, don't fold it so that these exactly touch in the middle. Fold it so that there's just a smidge of a space. So we'll say, you know, about a 16th of an inch of a space between the fabrics in the middle here. That way there, when you fold it in half again, you don't end up with bulk here in this seam, making it not as nice and kind of bulky and looks like there's, you know, a bubble there, I guess you could say. So leaving that little gap helps with that bubble or bulkiness here in this seam. So that's how you do those two options. So that's option two and option three for you. So choose the one that's best for you, given the materials you have. The one I'm doing is best for really thick fabrics, and I know my fabric's not really thick, and I'd be able to sew the four layers or the three layers, but I'm just choosing to do this so I can walk you through what to do, because this is a different method that we might not have seen, just like option two. You might not have seen these before, or maybe you have. It's just a different method, and I thought it would be really neat to show in the video. So the first thing you're going to do is take your double-sided tape and place some of it along this top edge here, so all along that top edge. And if you don't have double-sided tape, don't worry, you can always use a little bit of glue. You will have to let the glue stick dry before you use it, before you sew. And this is the glue stick here. So usually what I do if I'm using glue stick on a material like a vinyl or cork, something that can't be touched with an iron, I put the glue stick on and I put something heavy on top and I leave it sit overnight so it dries, so that way there when I start the next day, this is dry and it won't gum up my needle because it's wet glue. But that's why I like double-sided tape, is there's no waiting on anything to dry. You just get started. So double-sided tape along that one long edge. And if you're using a canvas, you can probably press this with your iron. If your canvas is okay to be pressed with your iron, you can just press this directly in half with your iron. So now that I have the double-sided tape along this top edge here, I'm going to fold this long edge to meet the other long edge. So you're literally just folding this directly in half. Just like that. So now we have it folded in half. So now it's half the width of what it was when we first cut it. Now what we need to do is top stitch down the long edge. And the edge that you're going to top stitch down is from the folded edge, not from this edge where the raw edges are, but from the folded edge. So we're going to top stitch down that edge using the seam allowance given in the pattern. And And this one has two rows of stitching, so you'll want to make both rows of stitching. We'll trim all our threads, and I'm returning my stitch length too, back to the length I use for stitching a bag together. Just cutting all those threads because there is a lot that were kind of messy. So I've stitched two rows of stitching from the folded edge. So here's my folded edge. I have a row of stitching here and a row of stitching there. So I've done that stitching. Now you're wondering, well, what are we going to do with this edge here that has no stitching and doesn't have any, no stitching and it has that raw edge? What we're going to do is from the folded edge, we're going to measure and we're going to cut off this side here that isn't stitched at all. So I'm going to go off camera because I need to measure and cut, and I'm going to do that. And I'm going to use the measurement given in the pattern from the folded edge over to be able to cut this off. And I'll come back and I will show you how it looks. All right, so I've trimmed off that little piece that I said was on the side that I needed to trim off. Again, I measured from this folded edge over and used the measurement given the pattern for how wide this finished strap will be. And then here's the piece that I cut off. I'm not gonna actually throw this out because I can probably use this on another project for another wrist strap. It may be a little bit smaller, or actually it's about the same width as this one. And that's okay because I'll just stitch down the two sides and it'll be raw edge on both sides. Maybe I'll make another one of these in a smaller size using the same material. So I have a coin purse one or with the bigger one, and it kind of matches a cute little set. So this is done. We can place this to the side for now and move on to the next step. And the next step is deciding whether you're making a single card slot, the double, or the triple. You should have already decided when you cut out your materials. However, if you didn't because you kind of wanted to wait to see what was happening, this is the time to now decide what you're going to be doing. And you'll need your, if you're like me, I'm using the lining, that's what I'm using for the large. But if you're doing the single card slot, you can actually put that in the front on this exterior front piece so that it's inside your card, your pocket here, this front pocket that's going to be on the front. You can do one in there, and then you can do one in the lining as well. So you have a couple of options. You can really make this your own and do what you want. It's a really good base with all the different options for making extra card slots or whatever you want. So because I am doing the large and I'm doing a triple card slot, this is how mine is going to look. It's going to go on here, just like that. So I've gone ahead and I've made my mark from the bottom up, and I've also marked where the center is. So I've done that. Once you have made the mark from the bottom up, and the bottom is going to be the wider part where your zipper isn't. So this is the wider part. So once you've done that, just place that off to the side and grab your card slots. And this is again where you'll need to have your decision for which ones you're going to want to make. And I accidentally cut my card slots upside down, but then I thought, you know what, it's kind of cute when you look into the wristlet, you're going to see the cats looking at you. So I thought, that was kind of cute. So I'm going to add some double-sided tape to this just to help hold it in place while I'm sewing, because I don't want it to shift on me. So I'm just adding some double-sided tape outside of the seams. So I'm just going to do that now so that I can really make sure that everything stays in place. And you don't have to add as much as I'm adding. You can add just one little single strip, but I'm just really going to place it because I'm just worried about everything shifting on me. Was trying to turn it without breaking the tape, but it didn't want to turn. And again, I'm keeping it so that it's going to be out of the seam allowance because I don't want it to be seen after. So I'm not going right on the edge. And again, you can use a little less tape if you prefer. All right, so remove all the paper backings. I'm just removing all my paper backings. Sorry if this is taking too long. You can definitely fast forward the video at any point or zoom in, whatever you need. So now I'm going to place the card slots on top of each other, and I'm going to line everything up, and I'm going to make sure I'm lining it up nicely and perfectly. So flipping it over, making sure the right side lines up. If you have to do any trimming, you definitely can. Sometimes when we cut, it's not always perfect. So there you go. I have my lining attached to my exterior, so they are wrong sides together. So you need to remember that they are wrong sides together. Now, for this, we're going to top stitch the top edge of our card slots. And again, I've chosen the card slot with an angle, so there was options for a more rounded card slot or this V's like I've done here. So you get your choice, which I really like. So now we're going to top stitch the top edge all the way around, and no back stitching, all the way on the top. We're going to top stitch that. So I'm going to bring this to my machine, switch to my length for top stitching that I like, and there'll be no back stitching. And what you will do, you're going to leave long tails, and then we'll pull them through and tie them off. And I'll show you how to do that. So no back stitching. And I know it'll feel weird. I have to keep talking to myself as I'm stitching all the time for no back stitching. And just take your time here. There's no need to rush, so that you get really nice stitching. And if you're working on that curved edge, the one that has the curve, the rounded edge, what you'll do as you're going around the curve is take your time and pivot at each curve. So as you're curving, so take a stitch, leave your needle down, lift up your presser foot, and pivot just a little bit, presser foot down, take another stitch, and then continue doing that, lifting the presser foot up, pivoting, and taking another little stitch as you go around, and that'll help you get a really nice curve. And you can do that anytime you have anything that has a curve. So I'm back where I started, pulling them through, and now we need to grab an awl or a seam ripper. I'm just going to use my scissors because they're small and pointy. And you're going to take your bobbin thread and give it a little pull. And what that does is it causes the top thread to come through to the back like a loop. You put your scissors or your awl or whatever you're using in the middle of the loop and just pull. And we'll do that again on the other side. So just give your bobbin thread a little tug, and that causes a little loop. Scissors in the middle of the loop or whatever tool you're using. And then you pull the other thread through. And now we will tie this off. I'm just tying a knot. And we're going to repeat that for any other card slots or any slip pockets that we're making. So I am adding the slip pocket. So I'm going to do the same thing for my slip pocket. The same thing you just watched me do here, I'm going to do for my slip pocket. And I will do that on camera. Normally I would turn the camera off and I would go do that on camera. But I'm going to show you again just so that you can see how it's done. And I will add some double-sided tape again. Sorry, you need to sit through that again. You can just fast forward so you're not watching me do the double-sided taping. I like having these like little sew-alongs, these tutorials, so that anybody who's new can follow along and keep up. And also I like to give lots of information in between for some tips and tricks. so that's sewn. I'm going to put that to the side, but you can see here on this side, you can see all my stitching. So I'm going to put that to the side, and I'm going to grab my slip pocket piece. And I went with the same V shape for my slip pocket, just so that it matches the card slots. And again, you can add a single card slot underneath your front pocket, that front zipper pocket piece, if you want. You can just do a single card slot, you can do a double card slot, whatever you want. I'm doing the triple again because it does have a few more steps in terms of sewing and how we sew it. So I wanted to show you, because if I show you the triple, you can do the double or the single. It's a really cute little pattern, and I like how quickly it comes together. It takes a little bit longer when I'm filming tutorials because I go into so much detail, but it's a really cute little pattern, and it'll be great for if you have, you know, a craft fair or anything that you need to go to and you need something that you can whip up really quick. You can do it in different fabrics, different materials, I mean, different color combinations. You can make some really dressy ones, some really cute fun ones like I'm doing here. I find this really cute and fun. So you can really have fun with this little pattern. So there's the slip pocket again, wrong sides together, and I'm going to top stitch that top edge, leaving long tails. And again, we'll find the bobbin thread, give the bobbin thread a little tug, and that'll pull the top thread through to the back, just like that. And this is another great method to use if you're, say you're top stitching a strap, because this has happened to me many times, and your thread runs out while you're top stitching your strap. You can unpick a few stitches back, pull them through, tie it off, start stitching in the same hole you stopped in, leaving long thread tails, and continue stitching along until you get to the end. When you're done stitching all the way to the end, what you can do is come back, pull the tails the same way through to one side and tie them off, and then just trim them short. And if you're worried about it, you can add a little dab of fray stop or fray check or any seam sealant, some glue, and that'll help secure it in place. There is another technique where you can pull them through the layers, but that's a little bit harder to explain on camera. I need to show you how to do that. And I believe I did in another tutorial. I can't remember which one though. So there's my slip pocket all stitched across the top. Now, we need to place our card slot on top of our piece that we're putting it on. So again, I'm using the large and the triple card slot. So I want to place this on the inside of my bag, but you can do one, like I said, on the exterior underneath that front zipper pocket, and then do one inside here as well. The choice is really yours. Make this exactly how you want it to be. So what we need to do is, there is a measurement again, as I was mentioning, there's that measurement that you want to use from the bottom up, and you want to make that measurement and then draw your line and use a pen that you can either erase, so this will come off with water, or a chalk pen so that you can erase it, because this is vinyl and you want to use something you can get off the vinyl. And then we're going to place our card slot centered and on that line. So I'm going to use a wee bit of tape just to help hold it in place. And I'm putting this along the edges, just the side edges. I don't think I need the bottom so much. All right. So I'm going to find where my center mark is, and I'm going to line it up with that center mark and line up the line. I do need the tape on that bottom edge because it won't. There we right. So I'm lining this up with that line and my center line. So centering it and lining it up with the line here that we made. Oops. Now it's sticking too much. There we go. So I've got it centered and I've lined it up the bottom edge of the pot of the card slot with the line here that I drew, and it's centered, nicely centered. So now we need to stitch this in place. And this is where I was saying the triple card slot is stitched just a wee bit different. If you're doing the single, you'll just go down one side, across the bottom, and back up the other side. We're doing the double here, or the triple here, or you might be doing the double. So for this, we need to come down one side, go across, come up at the one edge, and then back down, come across, back up at this edge, down, come across, back up at this edge here. And that's what we're going to do to stitch that in place. So what I need to do is I need to draw my lines because I didn't do that yet. So I need to draw the lines in the center here. So I'm going to go off camera and I'm going to draw my lines for where I need to stitch because I want to make sure I have these accurate so that my cards can fit in after. And I'm going to grab a card too, because once I'm done stitching, I'll check to see if everything is okay. Well, not stitching, sorry, drawing my lines. I'll check to make sure that where the lines are drawn will be okay for my card and it'll fit. So I'm just going to go off camera. I'm going to draw my lines for where I need to stitch my stitching lines, and I'll come back and we will continue on. All right, so I drew those lines and I grabbed a card too just to measure, and I can see where my lines are here. So I'm measuring in the center of those lines with the card, and the card will fit beautifully in there. So that's good. That means that I've cut and measured everything accurately, but also if I needed to make any changes, now would be time to make note of those changes. So again, we're going to stitch down one side, across the bottom, up on that line, then we're going to pivot and come back down that line, across the bottom, up that next line, back down, and back up. And I just want to make sure I'm giving you the right instructions for that. To stitch. So you're stitching down across the top, across the bottom, and back up. And you can, so you can do that. You can go down the side, across the bottom, back up, and then just stitch up these lines. Don't backstitch, leave long tails. However, I'm going to go down, across the bottom, up, then I'll turn around and come back down, go across the bottom, back up, turn around, come back down. That'll just give some extra security in those stitch lines here for the amount of use that you'll be pulling on these. That'll just add some extra security there on those card slots. So I'm not using my top stitch length or the length I use when I stitch my bags together. I'm just using a stitch length slightly longer than my usual stitch length. So no back stitching, starting up at the top here. Just stitch along. So I'm turning now and I'm coming up the top here, up this one side. Now I'm going to turn and I'm going to go right back down, and I'm not stitching directly in those holes I just made. I'm kind of beside them, like right beside it. And I want to make sure I stop so that I get the same seam all the way across the bottom, so it looks like one seam straight that I didn't stop stitching. So stitching up, stop off so that it holds it on the edge here, pivot, and then I'm coming back down right beside the stitches, not directly on top of those previous stitching. And I'm just trying to get my needle. I want it to be seamless across the bottom. There we go. So it looks seamless straight across. one continuous line of stitching. So no back stitching, long thread tails. And same thing we did previously for this, and I want to make sure because there's some that go a little bit different. Now you can back stitch at start and stop, but I'm doing this because I don't want any back stitching. So I'm pulling them through and tying them off. I just like how it looks without all the back stitching. So tying them off. Sometimes I also find too much back stitching can damage your vinyl and perforate it, and you end up getting it ripping. So the less back stitching, the better, depending on the vinyl you're using. These are kind of long, they're hard to tie when they're that long. And again, you can add a dab of glue or some fray stop, anything you want to seal these so they don't unravel. If you're gluing them, allow them to dry before we continue on to the next step. There we go. And that is how your card slots will look. So you can try it out, slip some card slots, a card in there into each of the card slots, just like that. Beautiful. It works. They fit. That's how it looks so far. Super cute. Now this here, I'm just going to use some water after, and I'm going to erase it with water because that'll come off. No problem with water. Now we're going to sew our zipper pocket, and that is pieces B that you need, and your zipper pocket piece. And I'm going to show you how to sew a slip pocket. So I just want to see too if I can put my slip pocket where it will go. So the, oh sorry, the card slot, oops, I made a mistake. The card slot was supposed to go on this other side here, on the opposite side. I put it on the wrong side. It's supposed to go on the opposite side. That's my fault. Sorry about that. But you can put it on this side. It will work because when this is folded, it will still be right sides up. You won't have a problem. It'll just be on the other side of the card slot. So you do want it here. Sorry, that was my fault. I jumped ahead and misread that. So you can put that on there, and then your slip pocket, you can put it on the other side here. If you want, you can put your slip pocket there. So your card slot would be here and your slip pocket would be on the other side. So you can put your slip pocket there, or you can put your card slots again so that they go inside this zipper pocket. So the card slots or the slip pocket, I'm going to go and make the measurement and put my slip pocket here on this side, and I'll come back and I'll show you how it all looks when it is done. So I decided to show you how I'm stitching this one now because it is stitched sort of like you would your single card slot. So you down one side, across the bottom, and back up the other side. And again, no stopping, no back stitching. You can back stitch if you want. I'm choosing not to, so I'm leaving long thread tails. And really, even though in the instructions this is on this side, having it on that side is okay too, because I do have both these in here inside the interior of my wristlet. So as long as they're both there, it really doesn't seem to be making a difference, because you still can get inside the wristlet and reach both things. So I'm just pulling the thread through to the back. And then I'm going to tie them off just like I did previously. And now I have a slip pocket inside and card slots inside. And again, I didn't backstitch because I don't want any backstitching to show. It wouldn't have been too bad on the material I chose for my card slots and my slip pocket, because it is a busier print, so you won't see it as much. But I am worried about perforating the vinyl. So there we have it. I have my slip pocket here and my card slots. And when I go off camera again, I'll erase these marks I made here with my Frixen pen so that I can get rid of them. Now back to what we were doing, which was the zipper pocket. And you need the two piece B, and you also need your zipper pocket zipper. If you haven't already, you can go ahead and install your zipper pull. I've already installed mine. I do have a little tutorial on my YouTube channel. I will link that below for how to install a zipper pull onto some zipper tapes. So what you need first is you need the exterior piece, and you're going to flip this so it is wrong sides up. Then we're going to take some double-sided tape and we're going to place it along the long edges of the zipper. Now you can do this where this pocket here is left unlined, so you wouldn't have a second side. You can do that if you want, and it'll just be the raw edge side of your vinyl or whatever you've chosen to use. For the tutorial, I chose to do it with the lining fabric so I could show you exactly how to do it. But if I make it again, I will probably just leave my pockets and my card slots and my slip pocket with nothing behind it. And maybe even my exterior too. I might actually only leave it with that. So now we need to center this in the zipper pocket. So center it right along the zipper pocket. Make sure the teeth are centered in the zipper pocket opening. Excuse me. Sticking to my nails. All right, so centering it, perfect. I got it centered. So it'll look just like this, and I'm just going to make sure that there's enough going over the edges so it's centered. So that's how you want it to look. So that's the front side, and that's the back side, and that's how you want it to look. Now we need to place some tape above and below the zipper. So on the zipper, at the top and the bottom of the zipper, on the wrong side, because we're going to attach the lining to it. And then we're going to place some double-sided tape in the center here, just to help hold everything in place for you. Remove the paper backings, just like that. And with the lining wrong sides together, get everything lined up. And this is going to be a little bit tricky because you got to get that lined up within the zipper, but also at the top and bottom edges and the side edges. So it might take a bit of maneuvering, but it's actually not too bad because you've cut everything so you can line up the edges. And if you want, you can actually even use more double-sided tape to really help hold everything in place instead of clips like I'm doing here. So now, leaving long tails, we need to sew all around this zipper opening. So leave your long thread tails, starting at one short edge. We're going to start stitching all the way around. And again, you're starting on one short edge, no backstitching. If you really want, you can backstitch. If you're using a busier print and you're not concerned about backstitching showing, but we're sewing all the way around the zipper tape right now. And that's attaching this to our lining and our exterior. And that's enclosing the raw edge of the zipper as well. So you'll have no raw edges showing on the lining side because it's in between the exterior and lining wrong sides. And just stitching all the way around. Going to come back down the side I started at. Oh no, I ran out of bottom thread. So this is a good way for me to show you what I was talking about earlier about coming back and unpicking your stitching. So you just keep unpicking your stitching back a bit. I'll have to go off camera and wind another bobbin. I was hoping there was enough in here for this whole project. But there wasn't. So I've got enough to make a tail and tie it off. So I'm just pulling the front thread through to the wrong side and I will tie it off. And actually, I'll do as she instructs in the pattern, which is you pull them through, so you open this up and I can pull them through here. Being careful not to clip any threads or anything. And see, they're coming through. I pulled it through the middle. I just found the two threads and I pulled them through to the middle. And now I'm going to tie them off. And that's what you can do if you had it on the side of a strap where the seam is, where it's folded. So you could pull them through that folded edge where the two sides meet in the middle, you know, where the, I'll show you on this, where's my strap. So say this was the two folded edges here, you could pull it through this seam here and tie them off. That just fell on the floor. And then when I start stitching again, I'm going to do the same thing, pull them through here and tie them off. And then you don't see any back stitching or anything at all. So I'll have to come back and do that once I get my bobbin wound. So I'm going to go ahead and go wind my bobbin, oops, and then I'll come back and we will continue on making our Speedy Wristlet. All right, so now I'm going to continue sewing all the way along, and I'm going to, again, pull those threads through between the layers like I did when I ran out of bobbin thread. And we'll also do that here on the side, too. We'll pull our threads through. So I'm going to remove a few clips, find where my threads are, and this might be a bit trickier because you have lots of threads going on here. I think I'm just going to pull these ones to the back. It's a little too hard for me to pull this open as much as I want to. So I'm just going to pull it through to the back. That'll be okay. So the knot will be small enough, I won't see it. I can't pull this open as wide as I want because of the previous stitching and knot. So it's hard to see, and I don't want to cut or break any threads. There we go. And you really don't notice that knot. Plus this will be on the inside, no one's really going to see that. It's going to be very hard for them to see that. Now here is where I can, because I can pull this apart. And I can pull the threads through. just find out where they are and pull them through. And this is a little bit tricky. It's a little bit time consuming and tricky, but you can do it. Just make sure you're not pulling the same threads you've already pulled through. This is a bit time consuming, I'm very sorry. Again, if this is boring for you, go ahead and fast forward through. So there's the loop of the second one that's in the front. Pull it through to the back. And now I gotta find this one's loop. Maybe using blue wasn't a good color to choose, but this. No, that's not it. It's hard to find it. Don't want to pull the wrong thread because then you're going to end up with no stitching in certain areas. I don't think I have the right one. I'm going to pause this and do this off camera because this is really boring for you to try and watch me fiddle with. But you have to be careful trying to get the threads out from the center here, and then we'll tie them off. All right, finally, that was a little bit of work trying to get those pulled through, but I have all four pulled through to the center between the exterior and lining layer. And again, just take your time and really make sure you're grabbing the right threads. You don't want to pull out any stitching. And you're just knotting them off. It would have been easier if I used a darker thread. I would have been able to see them better. It made it really hard to see them. And if you're not concerned about backstitching and you don't want to fight with this way, definitely go ahead and do the backstitching. Especially if you're using a material, like I was saying, that is busy and you won't see the backstitching as much, you can do the backstitching. So that's how it looks. There's no backstitching anywhere. I've pulled my thread tails through to the center here, so you don't see them because it's between the layers. Now we're going to top stitch all the way around this zipper pocket using the seam allowance given in the pattern. And again, no backstitching. We're going to leave those long tails again. And you want to start on the side or an edge along the bottom long edge or one of the side edges. Make sure everything stays lined up. Oh, I'm using the wrong seam allowance. I'm thinking of when we stitch together in the final stages. So I'm just unpicking all my stitches. So I think I can just probably pull the bobbin thread. No, I'm gonna pause this, unpick those stitches, sorry about that, and come back. Very sorry about that. I didn't mean to make that mistake. I was thinking top stitch, as in when we top stitch it to our bag. So you're going to use the seam allowance to top stitch this. That's given in the pattern. And again, no back stitching at all. And I'm just trying to make sure all my materials stay lined up as I stitch this. And I'm starting on the side seam here. No back stitching, because we will pull our thread tails through to the other side. And I just like to pivot and check when I get down to this corner here to make sure that I'm keeping an accurate seam allowance. And if I'm not, I take one more stitch and then turn and keep going. And when you get up to where your zipper is, you want to be careful if you have a dangly zipper pull that you don't have it dangling under your presser foot or near your presser foot or your needle so that you don't hit it and break a needle, damage your machine. So there it is here. I'm just going to zip it that way so it's right out of my way. Shifting away on me. And now I'm coming back down the side I started, and I'm going to stop right in that same hole I started in. Pull my thread tails. Just fixing my presser foot. And now we're going to pull the thread tails to the lining side and we'll tie them off. And this time you're not pulling them through between the layers, so it's a little bit easier. Trying to find out which one it is here in the front. I don't think this light blue thread was the best option to use for this tutorial because it's a little bit hard to see against this white material. So we're just trying to get them so we can pull them through. There it is, I can see it there. There we go. So now you take them and put them in a set of two, and we tie them off in a little knot. And again, you can put some seam sealant or anything you want on these just to help with the knots. I've never had any issues with my knots. So hopefully nothing happens now because I've just said that. Give myself bad luck. So now we need to take our scissors and we're going to trim the lining away from the exterior. So this extra piece here, all the way along, without snipping where our stitches are. So just out of the seam allowance. And this will help keep it so that you don't see it when we stitch this pocket onto the exterior of the bag. And duckbill scissors are great for this because it's helping hold my exterior down. So I'm not cutting my exterior, and I can see where my stitches are, so I'm making sure I'm not cutting my stitches. And I don't want to cut that knot off, so I'm just held it with my finger so I didn't cut the knot. And this is why we didn't put that tape along the edge here, because we had to peel this back to trim this off. If you don't have duckbill scissors, this is one thing I really like having, and it was a very worthy investment for things like this. So if you don't have any, I really do suggest investing in a pair. Any pair, it doesn't matter. They are sold everywhere, local quilt shops, online, Amazon. They're really handy to have because, like I said, it makes sure that exterior fabric is protected, or whatever fabric you're trying to not cut, away from the fabric you're trying to cut, and then you don't accidentally make any accidental snips. So now that that's cut, we need to place this on top of our exterior. And again, there's a measurement and a mark in the pattern for where to make this, and that's what I was saying at the beginning, that I already made the mark from the bottom up, and that's for where this is going to go. Now I need to find the center of my pocket, because I had that drawn on the lining piece, but I trimmed it off. So now I need to find the center of my pocket. So I'm just folding it in half, and I'm making the mark for where that center is. And we're going to place this at that mark given in the pattern. So that's where it's placed, right here. And I want to make sure I'm telling you the correct side. On the wider side, yes. So it's on the wider side. And you can tell by how far the distance is. So it is on the wider side, so I did do that right. Again, with the lining, it doesn't really matter where you had the card slots or the slip pocket. So now I'm going to use some double-sided tape. Excuse me. To hold it in place. And I'm going to use it along the bottom and along the sides. And again, we're going to stitch this without backstitching. And again, if you're not concerned about not having backstitching because you're using something that's really busy, then you can definitely go ahead and backstitch. As you can see, backstitching, it does require a little bit of work. It is totally worth it though, because you don't have any of the backstitching at all. Oh, I forgot the top edge. And we're going to place this on top of our exterior, so lining side down and exterior right sides up. And it's going on the exterior main A piece. Oops. Even my cat is sneezing in the background there. A lot of pollen flying around outside. Not good for allergies. All right, so I have my center mark. So I'm going to, from the bottom edge, place this from the bottom edge up and line up those center marks on my pocket and line it up with that line. And again, I'll take this over after and I'll use some water to erase that, because this can be erased by water. Oh my God, look how cute this looks. Oh my gosh, so cute. Love it. So now, no backstitching. We will stitch this on. I'm going to start along the bottom edge. No backstitching, and just stitch it all the way around. To stop where I started. You can actually get away with not doing this because it's pretty busy. I didn't realize how busy of a print this is. So there's one coming up from the back and another. we're going to tie them off. It's kind of hard when they're not the same length, I find. And just be careful how tight you're pulling on your threads when you're tying it, because I have had threads break on me as I'm pulling really tightly on them. So just be careful when you're pulling them to tie them off. So then that's how your pocket looks. It's now all stitched in. We have the exterior and lining. How cute. And you could have a card slot in there if you want. This is where we see sort of how it's going to look. This is really big. This is how we're going to see how it's going to look. Now we need to add the lining to the exterior. So we're going to need our zipper, our lining, and our exterior. Oh, the tape is stuck to my finger, it doesn't come off. Now, what you're going to do is take your zipper for your zipper opening here and place some double-sided tape along the top edge and the bottom long edges of your zipper, just as we did for that zipper pocket. And if you really just want a simple wristlet and you don't want to have that front pocket on there, you can go ahead and omit that. If you don't want to have your card slots inside, you can omit that. It really is your choice for this. This is your own, so just make it your own. So now we need to center this exterior over our zipper. And I want to have it so that both my zippers are pointing in the same direction when closed. So they both close the same way and open the same way. And I'm going to stand for this so that I can see what I'm doing, because a bird's eye view is always better for me than with it on the table. Just like that. Now we're going to repeat the same thing, but with the lining. So tape, same thing we did for that zipper pocket. And I'm going to put some tape in the center here, down here. Just to help make sure that's in place. Move your paper backings and install your lining over top. So again, I'm going to stand so I can see what I'm doing, and I'm lining up my bottom edges here first, and then that should get me all lined up on the sides. And see how it just perfectly, when I lined up that first bottom edge, when I brought it back up, it lined up perfectly here in the zipper window. This all lined up beautifully and perfectly. Now I'm going to add some clips just to help hold this in place as I'm stitching that zipper window. I'm having fun with this little bag because it's so cute. Really cute to take to the beach. Put your car keys in, have your ID with you, and one of your, if you need some cards or some cash. Really cute little wristlet for the beach, or, you know, if you're going out for a quick walk, say you have a dog and you take your dog for a walk, you know, and you just want to have your few pieces of ID with you and some cash, this is a really great wristlet for that too. Lots of great options. Good for a student, say university or college student, they don't want to bring a big bag with them, a big purse, and they just want to have a few items with them. This is really great for that too, because it has all the different sizes. Or for yourself, you know, if you're going, say, to somewhere fancy and you just want to have a really small bag with you, this is perfect for that. Obviously the large is a bit bigger, but it would be a good bag this size even, where you could put some stuff inside. Say you need to bring a brush with you or whatever, you could put it all inside and you're set. Now we're going to sew around this zipper opening. Again, no backstitching. Zipper opening. As I'm approaching my zipper pull, so I'm just going to move it out of the way. And these zipper tails, I want to make sure they're staying out of the way as well, the first set of zipper tails, because I don't want to run those over with my sewing machine, with my thread. So I don't want to put any stitches over it. So I want to make sure they're out of the way. You know, when I picked to do the large, I knew it was large, but I'm just looking at it and I'm like, wow, this is really big. All right, so I'm back where I started. Long thread tails. This is always the hardest part, is seeing this thread. Hopefully I can do this fairly quickly. Them so they're similar lengths, tie them off. A lot of this is, I think, what makes this take the longest is all the tying off. But again, if you don't mind the backstitching, you can definitely just backstitch. I just like the way this looks. It's in the pattern, but I also like the way it looks. Thread. There we go. Whoops. We have it all stitched in place. My zipper pocket works. That's the other thing I wanted to do. Just make sure that your zipper pocket works. I have had times where I've actually forgotten to put my pull on. So what I do when that happens is I just unpick a bit of the stitches back here and I come back a bit and pull them through like I did previously, tie them off. Unpick over here, pull them through, tie them off, and then I put my pull on. And again, that little video I have on my YouTube channel that I'll link below, that'll show you how to get your pull on, and that just makes it really easy. It's really easy to get it on once you have, even once you have it stitched in place, you just have to unpick the stitches. Now here you could have pulled them through the layers and tied them off. I just decided to pull them through to the back to tie it off. I didn't want to spend all that time doing that, just because it makes it take it a little bit longer. Now I'm going to top stitch around this whole exterior, same way we did for that zipper pocket. So we're going to end up with two rows of stitching when this bag is finished. So I'm going to stitch all the way around using the seam allowance given in the pattern. And we're going to be doing the same thing we did for that front zipper pocket, where we trim back the lining from the exterior. so that it doesn't show when this is all sewn together. It's kept in the seam allowance and it's all hidden. Those thread tails through to the back. And then we tie them off. I just trim them all the same length, put them in twos. As you can see, that one was much easier for me to pull through for some reason. Then we'll grab our scissors again with the duck bills. I can't say it enough, it is a worthwhile investment in getting duck bill scissors. All right, so now we're going to trim the lining out of that seam allowance, and this just keeps the lining from poking through the finished edge. So you only have one edge of, well, two because it's folded in half, but you don't have the lining, you just have the exteriors. And this doesn't have to be the prettiest cut, just as long as you get it cut out of the way, as close to your stitching without cutting your stitching. All the way around. There we go. Cut all the way around. So now we have this. Now we need to install our wristlet here. So if you're adding the wristlet, we need to install the wristlet. And for that, we will place it. So if you're using hardware or no hardware, you'll place it here, lining it up with the zipper. So just like this, lining it up with your zipper opening. So you'll place it just like that and make sure it's not twisted. So it'll go one here, just like that. And there's a measurement for how far in it will go, and the other one will go like that. And there is a measurement for how far in it'll go, just like that. Sorry, I'm trying to move my hands out of the way. So see how it's lined up with that zipper opening? And I like to have it where the top is, just so that you see, where the zipper closes, sorry, just so that when you're holding it, the zipper is up near your hand. So now we're going to make the, I think I skipped ahead, hang on. We need to make the connector. I'm just trying to find it in the pattern. For adding the connector, and I think I was supposed to do this before I did my stitching here. That's okay, we'll just continue going with it. So before you do your stitching, you need to add in your connector before you do all your stitching. So that's my fault. So before you do that top stitching, it was sort of not where I could see this, and I totally forgot about that. So before you stitch your lining and exterior together, you're going to put in your connector. And I'm okay, my connector will be within the layer, so I'm fine with it. It's raw edge material, it won't fray. So doing it this way is for if you're not adding the little wristlet, doing it this way. If you're adding a wristlet, don't top stitch just yet. If you did, it's okay. If you're like me and you top stitched already, that's okay. So what I'm doing is I took my connector and I drew a line down the center. On both sides of the line, I put some double-sided tape, and now I'm folding the edges in to meet that center line. And these ones can touch. Remember I was saying with the strap, you don't want them to touch? These ones can touch. And what we will do is we will slide the D-ring onto the connector and fold the connector in half over the D-ring, just like that. Now I'm going to stitch them together on the short edge, so just baste them together, just so that it holds them, just so that it holds them together while I'm stitching everything in place. I didn't backstitch here, whoops. So now we need to add the connector, and there is a spot again where you're going to add it, and if you're adding two, it'll be in the same spot on both sides if you're adding two. I'm only adding one because I'm only having one wristlet, so I'm going to place it with the amount that it says over the edge here, and you want your D-ring to hang off the edge, so it'll be like this, off the edge of your material, and you're lining this up with that zipper window that you made, that zipper pocket window. And I'm going to use some double-sided tape to hold it down. And then what would happen here is you would have your lining that you would place so that this would go between the lining, and you would stitch this down over the lining. So what I'm going to do here is I'm actually going to go flip it over, and I'm going to stitch on top of that. And I know I'm going to have two rows of stitching there, but I'm going to stitch directly on top of my previous stitches. And I'm going to leave the long thread tails. Just like that. And that way there, I have stitched this down and I don't have to worry about it shifting on me. And it's a raw material, that I can leave raw, so I'm not concerned that it's not hidden within my lining right now. If you did the same thing as me and forgot about adding that, and you're using a material that can be raw, you can go ahead and just do what I did, or you can do the same thing I had mentioned before, which is unpicking some of your stitches just a little bit and then pulling them through to the raw, to the lining side here, and then unpick before and after where that would go. And because you're pulling them through and tying them off, nobody will ever see, just as long as you start in the same hole you unpicked up to and stop up in the hole here where you unpicked up to. No one will ever know that I didn't have it, because once this is folded in, even when you open it up, you're not really going to be able to look and see that there. So now we have that there, and now we need to stitch this all together. So what you need to do is take it and fold it so that the linings are touching, and you can use some double-sided tape here, which I think I will, just to really help hold it all in place. I don't want anything shifting on me. And you don't have to use double-sided tape. You can just use your clips if you want. Just make sure the double-sided tape doesn't hang off the edge so you don't see it after. And I'm keeping it inside that seam allowance as well. We're truly almost done after we're done this. This is the last step, is just folding this in half and stitching it, and then making our little wrist strap with the hardware. now we're going to fold this in half. So you're going to bring the bottom edge and the top edge to meet. And this is where I'm going to stand again so I can have a bird's eye view. So see here, I'm folding it directly in half so the linings are touching. So make sure everything is lined up along your edges. Lined up on the front and the back. Just make sure everything's lined up nicely. And then we're going to top stitch all the way around the entire bag. And I'm going to add some clips. I know I put some double-sided tape there, but I just want to add some clips just to really help hold everything in place as I'm stitching all the way around. And here's where we're going to top stitch all the way around, but we're going to back stitch on this one. And that'll just really help reinforce the tops here where we start and stop. All right, so when I open this up, I have my card slots here and my slip pocket there. So that's what I was saying. It doesn't matter what side the card slots and the slip pockets are. But when I open and close that, the zipper here on the front and the zipper on the back both open and close in the same direction. All right, and now to stitch this. And just be careful because there is that D-ring here, so we don't want it flipping underneath so that we hit it. And if you have to use a humper jumper to get over your D-ring, you can use a humper jumper. Long tails because I just find it's easier to cut my threads really close when I have those long tails. Sorry about the zipper banging on the table. And the clips I'll put away. So that's how it looks. Woo! All stitched up. Everything's all stitched in place. You have your fully functional wristlet right now. Now you don't have to add that little piece of hardware. You can just leave it like this, but I did add that little piece of hardware. Now we're going to create our little wristlet. And to do that, we need to grab our wristlet. So you can use one of the options that we mentioned earlier, one of the three to make your wristlet. I'm using the first option. So now we're going to slide our swivel hook onto our wristlet. And I just want to see how far on. So you slide it on, and then there's a measurement for how far, and I'm just using it off camera, for how far over it's going to go. So you fold it down over the swivel hook with the measurement given in the pattern. And then we'll wrap the other end of the clip up, or swivel hook, sorry, or wristlet, sorry, and we'll tuck it under that first one that we folded up. I can see a thread there. Now you can use a rivet here if you want. I'm just going to sew, seeing as that's what we did for majority of this bag. I didn't add rivets anywhere else, so I'm just going to sew this. So that's how it looks. So I tucked that. So here it is, here's the folded edge. this loose edge, bring it up, and I'm touching the bar of my swivel hook, and then I fold that other folded edge over it so it conceals that first raw edge, and that's how it's going to look. Now I'm just going to stitch across this. I hope my machine doesn't have a fit about all the layers. Backstitch a couple times, and then I'll do another row of stitches a little bit away from it. Again, you can add a rivet or Chicago screw here. I'm just going to stitch threads. I can hook my swivel hook onto my D-ring, and there I have it. I have my wrist strap attached, and you have made, maybe have added a second D-ring over here, and then you can have it as a crossbody bag. Let's see what the other options are. You can have it as a crossbody bag. You can have it as a hip bag. There's also an option for adding those two strap connectors here too, and sliding your fabric through and tying a little knot to make it a crossbody bag. There's lots of little options for this. It's really cute. The coin purse has a little swivel hook that sticks off that you can just clip it onto something. It'd be really cute to make a little swivel, or a little wristlet to go with this, slide it inside, and then you have your little coin purse to go with this little wristlet. How cute is that? So now we are done our Speedy Wristlet, and once you are done, don't forget, before you start using it, to take some pictures and post them on social media, including in the DEJA Designs Makers Group on Facebook, so that we can all see your beautiful Speedy Wristlets. I really do hope you enjoyed sewing along with me and maybe picked up a few tips and tricks along the way. Thanks for sewing with me. I hope you all have a wonderful day. Bye.